On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree. The partridge in a pear tree represents Jesus, the Son of God, whose birthday we celebrate on Christmas Day.
On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two turtle doves. These twin birds represent the Old and New Testaments. The doves are the biblical roadmap that is available to everyone.
On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me three French hens. These hens represent faith, hope, and love. This gift refers to 1 Corinthians 13.
On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me four calling birds. These four birds are the four books of the gospel: Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me five golden rings. These five rings represent the first five books of the Old Testament, known as the Torah or the Pentateuch.
On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me six geese laying. Each egg represents a day in the creation formed by God.
On the seventh day of Christmas, my true love gave to me seven swans a-swimming. The swans represent the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit: prophecy, ministry, teaching, exhortation, giving, leading, and compassion.
On the eighth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me eight maids a-milking. This gift represents the ones who would receive his word and accept his grace. The eight who were blessed included the poor in the spirit, those who mourn, the meek, those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, the merciful, the pure in heart, the peacemakers, and those who are persecuted for his righteousness.
On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me nine ladies dancing. The nine dancers are the fruits of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control.
On the tenth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 10 lords a-leaping. The lords in biblical days were judges and in charge of all the law. This gift represented the Ten Commandments.
On the 11th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 11 piper pipings. After Judas's betrayal, there were only 11 men who carried out the gospel message.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love gave to me 12 drummers drumming. The drummers are the 12 statements of belief. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the body of Christ, the church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
A thrill of hope. a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, the angel's voice says, arise, divine, oh night, oh, when Christ was born.
Welcome to Mount Olive Missionary Baptist Church. We are located at 920 Los Robles Boulevard here in Sacramento, California. Our church doors remain closed, but you can worship with us every Sunday right here on our YouTube channel. Thank you to those who continue to support our ministry with your gifts of tithes, offerings, and love donations. We greatly appreciate you. For those who wish to contribute, you can give three ways: by mailing your contribution directly to the church, in person, every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m., or you can give electronically online. The link can be accessed on our website and also in the description. During the week, we have midday Bible study on Wednesdays at 7 p.m., and every Sunday at 9 a.m., we have adult Sunday school. Also, every Sunday morning at 11 a.m., we have children's church on Zoom. All services are featured on Zoom, and all links to the Zooms can be found in the description. Please continue to be safe, wear your mask, and remember to practice social distancing. If you want to grow more in the Word and you're looking for a place to worship, we hope that you would consider making us your church home. For more information about our church and any of our services, please visit our website, www.montolivembcsacramento.com. We hope that you are enjoying our Christmas celebration service and hope that you'll join us again next week. Be encouraged and be blessed.
I'd like to say good morning, good evening, midday, whatever time it is for you. We greet you today in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It is again, we have come in a time, a place, an occasion to say a word on God's program. Today, we would like to bless you from the third chapter, book of St. John. But before we do, we'd just like to pray and encourage your hearts during this coronavirus season. Let us pray. Father, it's again, we say thank you for our coming together. We ask that you would bless today as your word go forth. We ask that you would bless those that will hear, those that will believe and receive. It is again, we say thank you for all you have done, what you're doing, how you kept us, and how you are keeping us. Bless those that have been victims of the coronavirus. We ask that you would bless the loved ones in the name of Jesus. Bless our land, our country. Lord God, we ask that you would just bless our communities at large. Ask that you would bless marriages, families, and all in the name of Jesus. For we thank you now. We ask that you would bless your word as it go forth. Open our hearts, our minds, for we ask it all now in Jesus' name. Amen. Again, we've come at a time, a place, an occasion to say a word on God's program. Today, we would like to call your attention to the book of St. John. I just love the book of St. John. As I've said in the past, it just seems like brings out so much of the deity of Jesus Christ. Today we would like to talk about Jesus is the reason for the season. Jesus is the reason for the season we're approaching, perhaps the most celebrated holiday throughout the land and country, especially in our United States of America, what we call Christmas, the season. So we want to talk today from John chapter 3, verses 16 and 17, no doubt a very familiar passage of Scripture. I believe out of all of the Scriptures, I believe that this is the greatest verse. Perhaps it offers more than any other single verse in the Bible. And many of us, Sunday school goers and teachers and on from youth up, I'm sure we can remember and quote this passage of Scripture. Some Scripture just stands out, John 3:16. So today we want to talk about Jesus is the reason for the season. Let's look at John 3:16. I'm reading from the King James Authorized Version. John says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Look at verse 17. "For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." Jesus is the reason for the season. Now, if we back up at verse 9 and come down, we know that in chapter 3, Jesus began his ministry. And there was a man by the name of Nicodemus. And he had heard much about Jesus. Scripture said, but he wanted to go and see him for himself. So the scriptures say that he left his station, whatever he was doing. He took time out to go see Jesus, and it was nighttime. Could have been he didn't want to be identified or even see his fellow Sanhedrin members of the council, but he wanted to see Jesus for himself. It's a good thing for people to want to experience, have an experience with Jesus. So as Jesus met him and Nicodemus found him by night, notice, if you will, night, they didn't have the fabulous electrical lights like we have now of the lighting. The sun had gone down, so the natural light or the sunlight was not there. So Nicodemus couldn't have been blind physically, but he was blind spiritually. And he went and had a conversation with Jesus and said to him, Master, Rabbi, teacher, we know that no man can do these things except God be with him. And Jesus just cut the conversation short and just said right to him where he was, met him where he was. He knew the reason he had come to ask the question. And then he said to Nicodemus, "You can't even fathom, you can't see, you can't experience, you can't know how to get to heaven except you be born again." So Jesus goes in a conversation. And as we pick up in verse 9, we would just like to read, and we want to come back and share at least There are more, but at least 8 nuggets stands out in this perhaps message today. 8 nuggets all in verse 16. Let me read again to show you. It's Nicodemus. Nicodemus in verse 9 answered and said unto him, that is to Jesus, how can these things be? All that what he's doing. Jesus answered and said unto him, art thou a master of Israel and knowest not these things? You are a man over 70 years old. You have wisdom. You're a teacher. You're a member of the Sanhedrin and you can't understand these things. Notice in verse 11, always notice when Jesus repeats, use the word verily, verily, he is saying, surely, surely, truly, truly, as the old folks would may say, shown up, shown up. I say unto thee, we speak that we know and we testify that we have seen and receive not, and ye receive not our witness. Verse 12, he said, if I had told you earthly things and ye believe not, how ye believe if I shall tell you heavenly things? And no man has ascended into the heaven, but he that cometh down from heaven, even the Son of Man, which is in heaven. Nicodemus, the one you're talking to. Look at verse 14. And Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man, Nicodemus, be lifted up, the one you're talking to. Nicodemus, I am the one. Watch what he says in 15, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. That is the ending part of verse 16. So again, we want to talk about Jesus is the reason for the season. Let's look at reason. Reason. According to Webster, it's a noun, the name of a person, place, or a thing. Reason. The cause, the motive for an action from feeling. The reason is the cause or the motive for a action, for a feeling. We're going to talk about that later. This is the season of which we about to experience, the 25th day of December. Season, season. Let's look at it. Also, it's a noun. Season, any period of time. Watch this. That marks by something special. Any period of time marks by something special. Also, one of the four seasons of the period of the year. For example, spring, summer, autumn, or we call fall, and then winter, which is we experiencing now as I speak. Again, one of the most important scriptures, a passage of scriptures, a verses in the Bible, John 3:16. I shared that I was going to give you at least 8 nuggets from this passage. I'll call them off and then we'll come back and talk about them. Let's look at nugget number 1, for God. We're going to talk about that later. Nugget number 2, so love. Nugget number 3, the world. Nugget number 4, he gave. Nugget number 5, his only begotten son. Nugget number 6, that whosoever believeth. Nugget number 7, should not perish. Nugget number 8, have everlasting life. Let's talk about this. A nugget, something is precious, valuable to you or whoever. Nugget. Notice, if you will, in verse 16. Do you see it? For God. Who is he? He is the greatest person. Bible tells us that he is omniscient. He's omnipresent. He's omniscient. He's almighty, all-knowing, and he's all-present. So, the greatest person for God. We see that? That's nugget number one. Nugget number two. So love. The greatest devotion, a deep affection. Notice the love. We're not talking about Eros love. That's the love for we have for our sexual partners, wife, husband, and the list goes on. It's not talking about storage love, the love we have for our siblings, brothers, and sisters. And the list goes on. He's not talking about philo love, what we call friendship love, our homies, best friend, and the list goes on. But the love he's talking about here is the unconditional. He's talking about agape love. So if we have that, if we can receive that, then we're blessed among individuals. So God, so love. Watch this. What did he love so precious or so much? The world. World, the greatest number. Notice he's not talking about the universe, the sun, stars, and the moon. But he's talking about, watch this. He's talking about humanity, mankind, the world. He's talking about man. After our forefather Adam sinned in the garden, God loved us so that he didn't want to just and did not just destroy Adam and everything. He had something, a nugget in the rim for us at a later date. So the world in this sense is not the sun. It's going to disappear one day. The moon is going to disappear. The elements and all, the scripture tells us that one day they will melt with fervent heat and come down and burn up this earth. So the world he's talking about here is the makeup. Comes from the Greek word cosmos. The makeup, the system, mankind, all that is going against God's standard of what God approves of today. Let's look at nugget number four. He gave. Oh, my goodness. The greatest act of gift. You can't think of anything else in the world from beginning to the ending that is great as the act of God giving his son, Jesus Christ. He gave. No one can give. Even today as we speak, doubtfully if one of us would give up a member of our family for a cause or the sake of someone else on and on, but God. So he gave. Nugget number four, the greatest act of gift. The greatest act of giving. Watch it. What was it that he gave? Nugget number five. His only begotten son. Again, the greatest gift out of all of God's creation. His son, his only beloved son, stood out more than any of the creation or all of the creation. So his only begotten. Thank God for the love that he shed it forth in our hearts. As Paul talks about in Romans 5:5, I believe it is. He says, hope make it not ashamed, for the love of God has been shed abroad in our hearts by the work of through the Holy Ghost. So his only begotten son, the greatest gift. Nugget number six, that whosoever believe it. the greatest condition. The greatest condition. My. Just think about it as we speak. And if you have experience, will experience, guess what? We fit in this nugget number 6. Whosoever, you and I, we are part of this great condition. Whosoever, whosoever. Thank God that I'm a part of the whosoever. Whosoever believeth in him shall not perish. Watch it, watch it. So that was nugget number 6. Nugget number 7, should not perish. The greatest act of mercy, one of God's chief attributes. He has many, but 3 stands out. Love is number 1. Love, and then we got grace, and then we got mercy. Love. Look at love. Look at grace. And then look at mercy. Mercy is to keep you from getting what you rightfully deserve. Should not perish. The greatest mercy. And then nugget number 8. Have everlasting life. The greatest results. So as we said before, in this particular verse, it offers more than any other verse from Genesis to Revelation. John 3:16. It sums up the gospel in a nutshell, as the old folks would say. So as we look at it again, John 3:16, for God. He is the greatest person. So love, the greatest devotion, the deepest affection. The world, the human, humanity, the human race, not the sun, stars, or the moon. He gave, look at the greatest gift or the greatest act of gift. What was it? Number 5, his only begotten. He gave his best. I wonder today, what will we give in exchange? Jesus asked a question in his teaching, what will a man give in exchange for his life? What does it profit a man to gain the whole world and then lose his soul? So that was number 5. And then, as I said before, where you and I fit in, that whosoever believe it, doesn't matter what race, creed, color, year, or how old you may be, or whatever your conditions may be, but whosoever. And I just thank God as I speak today that I'm a witness, that I'm a part of the whosoever. And then number 7, thank God that I come into the knowledge of number 6, because I do not want to perish. In this life, we are destined for 2 places. You can't go to both of them, and you can't miss both of them. So in this life, we are destined for life or death, eternal damnation or eternal life with God. So it's up to us. Perish. As you see me, see yourself, feel your flesh, one day it will perish. It will be dissolved. But guess what? The spirit that's within you and the soul that God gave you when he breathed into the nostrils of man, Adam, in Genesis chapter 2, that's eternal. That's eternal. So your soul will have to spend eternity somewhere, whether it's with God or out of the presence of God. So Jesus came that you and I should not perish. And I'm so glad of number 8, that we can have everlasting life. And how we get this life is through Christ Jesus, believing as personal Lord and Savior. Not about denomination, not about religion. It's not about what group you stand in, but it's about a personal encounter relationship with Christ Jesus and an ongoing relationship. One that's in divine fellowship with God. So if you think about it today, perhaps we are thinking about celebrating what we call Christmas, which is not a biblical term, and how man have commercialized on it. And perhaps many people will undergo this particular Christmas day, as we call the 25th of December, sad because of what is going on in the world. Perhaps America and the world at large have not experienced what we are going through, the coronavirus. A little over 100 years ago, the record shows that we went through something similar, but not at this magnitude. So as we get ready to celebrate, there are a lot of people stricken, out of jobs, out of their home, losing their homes, and the list goes on. But still, some of us that can and will, we're planning to spend and to do a lot of shopping. Perhaps we've already done it. But think about, as we get ready to celebrate today, that Jesus is the reason for the season. It's not about the gifts you give. It's not about the beautiful tree, all of the shopping, what we do on and on. But the greatest gift that was ever given, when God gave his Son for you and I, that we might have a right to the tree of life. Let us pray for those that are less fortunate than we are. Let's help somebody. Let's aid somebody. And think about this. We don't know if Jesus was born. This is the day we set aside. Biblical history say that it could have been late October, or it could have been as early as October, as late as January. But this is the day we've set aside, the 25th of December, and it's celebrated throughout the land and country. And think about it as we get ready to celebrate it in the morning that we get up, if we are able to get up. Think about Jesus is the reason for the season. Think about blessing someone else during this season. Pray for someone else during this season. You that are able, you that can, let's share. And as we look at this season, it's about giving, giving. As God gave his Son, so you and I should be able to do something for someone. And the greatest gift that you can give them is the words of Jesus, and to lead them to Jesus with and through eternal life. We trust that you've been blessed. Jesus is the reason for the season. One of the greatest verses known to mankind. So in this verse, in this message today, only if we can think about Jesus is the reason for the season. Not about Santa Claus, not about so many of the gifts, and the list goes on. But think about whether he was born on the 25th of December, or late October, or even January. It's not so much matter in the date, but we do believe that he was born in the city of David, Bethlehem, over 2,000 years ago. Let's thank God. And as we celebrate, remember Jesus is the reason for the season. We trust and hope that you've been blessed. We're going to close in a word of prayer. And we thank God for allowing us to share again. Let us pray, Father. It's again, we said, thank you for the words that you've given us, the message. We pray that it would go forth and not return void. Lord, we ask that you would bless those that are preparing or will prepare for this season, this holiday. Let them know it's more about the gifts, Lord God. It's more about just giving gifts to someone, Lord God, but the season. Jesus is the reason for the season. Bless those that are less fortunate than we are. Bless those that have been stricken by the coronavirus. Bless those that have lost loved ones that perhaps will not be sitting at the dinner table this season. Lord, we ask that you would bless those that are less fortunate. No jobs, Lord God, in the food line. We ask that you would bless those that are sickened. We ask those that are stricken with the virus. We ask that you would just bless mightily today. We thank you for all you've done, what you're doing, what you're about to do. Lord, we give you the praise, honor, and the glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Christmas. Christmas.